All right, so at this point, I will welcome my presenter, Loredana Zordan, who is a midwife acupuncturist, and she's an independent midwife, freelance midwifery teacher, and she teaches a workshop for midwives on acupressure for pregnancy and birth. Of course, she does this nationally and across the globe. So, Loredana, at this point, I will make you the presenter. Sorry, just a minute. Okay. So, Loredana, you have the floor. Thank you very much. You're welcome to the IDM 2021. Loredana, you are muted.
Okay.
Yeah, so you can start again.
Okay. Thank you for inviting me to this conference. I'm very happy to talk internationally to this acupressure for pain relief in labor, because I really believe that more people, more women are use acupressure internationally. This is very important for me. We make a big change into the health of the woman. First of all, I would like to acknowledge Debra Betts and Sarah Butt for their inspiration, permission to share some of their material. You can go to the website Acupressure Resource from Debra Betts. You get a lot of information about leaflet. This is website very well done for women, can get a lot of information about pain relief in labor and other way they can use acupressure. First of all, what is acupressure? Acupressure is a part of a Chinese medicine technique, very old technique. It's been used in China for a very long time. Basically, instead of using the needle, which is the acupressure point, you apply pressure to the point. Okay, the same point you would use in certain needle. The acupressure points are situated in the channel or meridians. First of all, I need to discuss a little bit about the theory of Chinese medicine. It's a very big argument. However, just I'm going to talk about what is qi, what are the reasons. Qi can be translated as an energy of life force. It's the energetic form of vapor that makes us to live, basically. You cannot see this vapor, this energy, but has a very strong effect. Actually, it can actually lift the lid of the pot. Okay, qi flow to the channel, to the meridian, which are bilateral in our body, are like a network of river that travel our entire body and nourish and make us alive. In good health, qi moves smoothly through the channel. However, if you have a blockage of qi or deficiency or excess of qi, you can have a pain and illness. In Chinese, traditional Chinese medicine, mind and body is related. This is like a holistic approach. In labor, if a woman's got like, she's fair, she's like, she's got some fear, anger, or frustration, which is quite common in labor, especially if she's a first time mother, she was never in labor before, so she can have a fear. And this fear, this emotion can actually affect her body. She feel more the pain. And that's why you're using acupressure, as I said, the pressure, to blocking, to make this the qi circulating better. So I'm blocking this occlusion, she restore good health. Basically make the her body to feel better. Okay. How does acupressure work? Acupressure is a pain relief, it's not a block, it doesn't block the pain at all. It's not like an epidural, which takes pain away completely, just stimulating the body. Sometimes, not always the epidural works. However, acupressure stimulates the body to work more effectively, which results less pain, restore a balance, and block harmony on the body, okay? Certain points affect our brain, which know to reduce sensitivity to pain and stress. However, this does seem to increase endorphin. Endorphins are like hormones that our body produce when we're in pain. So basically, it will make us feel better just when you go to, for instance, do a physical activity or you are in love with somebody, basically your endorphin will increase. Another way of our cooperation work is increase the oxytocin. Oxytocin is just important in labor because it seems to sort of relax the woman, coping better with the pain. And as well, there is a certain point which actually definitely increase this oxytocin. And as well, I really believe that the therapeutic effect of acupressure is that touch, stay with the woman, supporting her, touching with the pressure, and still stay with her, make that she's got somebody, like create a safe healing space, which means that this will help him to decrease the pain perception and increase, as I said before, the symptoms. What are the advantages? There are many advantages by using acupressure. First of all, it's not an invasive technique, easy to use. You don't have to have a lot of knowledge of anatomy. Obviously, you need to know the point location, but then it's easy to use. What I tend to do, I tend to teach acupressure from 37 weeks. You can do teach actually during antenatal classes, half an hour session is enough, especially if you got the couple, you know, or it can actually provide, as I said, during antenatal classes or provide one-to-one session with a couple. Okay. More choice. What is that advantage? What does acupressure does? Offer more choice to women. As I say, is something that, you know, you can have, you know, generally you can have an epidural or you can have Entenox, other things, but in some reality, women don't have no access to any choice, any pain relief at all. So I think this is very useful, offer choice to women. Another thing which is very important, promote birthing pattern involvement. A lot of the time, from my experience, obviously women can choose to stay, to have a pattern she choose. I think that sometimes pattern raising is in labor, he doesn't know what to do. So I think it's just a way of making him feel aware, the person, the woman choose to be with her, making feel, helping her, the woman, okay? I believe that it definitely increased midwifery autonomy. This is very important, I think is, I feel as a midwife, when I support women in labor and offer acupressure, I tend to use a lot in my clinical practice. I believe that I can offer more. You know, this increases my autonomy. I don't have to rely on other people, anesthetist. I don't have to rely on doctor, or I got something to offer to women. This is really increasing my autonomy. As well, facilitate home birth. I tend to use a lot of acupressure for home birth, and for my experience, it's very good because it seems to sometimes, if it's a first-time mother, women might be transferred to labor ward because they want it, they want it pain relief, and you cannot offer any sort of epidural in home birth, obviously. So I think this is, women can stay at home. You can offer acupressure and then avoid to be into the hospital for obtaining pain relief. Another thing which is very practical, I tend to use acupressure on water birth, because we know that water birth, you know, you can have an epidural if you have a hotter water birth. And then women can really mobilizing on having, they can move around, okay? And as a whole, it seems to, using acupressure seems to reduce the medicalization of childbirth. I'm going to explain why. In fact, there's been some, it seems to empower women. You see, women feel there has been a research, more than around a compromised clinical practice, which is seen to women feel felt empowered through action, and acupressure give them the control and confidence to recover. They seen that they feel empowered in a way that they don't have to rely on other people, but they just rely on self. This is make them more satisfied, increase their self-esteem. And even midwife noticed that if they look after women, they're using acupressure, women feel more empowered. It's a sort of, they cope better with labor. And then another important thing about the reduced medicalization I mentioned before, what are the evidence? There are some evidence. that actually there's a randomized control trial that seen that acupressure reduced the need of epidural and cesarean section. Obviously, because it seemed to reduce the need of epidural, because the woman got better with the pain, the labor seemed less painful. And this is important for the reduction of medicalization because you will avoid cascade of intervention. If a woman receives an epidural, obviously she doesn't produce her own oxytocin, which is a pain relief. So even an epidural as well increase the medicalization of childbirth because increase the rate of instrumental delivery like a forceps and ventus, and that increase the possibility of laceration. So definitely it just like birth can be more natural, less complication. What are the adverse events? There's been some research that has reported no clinical issue about using acupressure, no premature labor or fetal distress. There might be some problem, minor adverse effect of bruising and pain, only if you apply too much pressure to the point. However, you need to go by the woman's feedback. The pressure you use, obviously, you tend to use stronger pressure during labor. However, during pregnancy and after birth, just you utilize gentle pressure. Okay, so definitely if you go by the woman's feedback, you shouldn't cause any problem. However, it's very important that you avoid certain points because they are point very effective for in labor induction. So bladder 32, bladder 60, gallbladder 21, large intestine 4, they must be avoided before 37 weeks because they are points that can induce labor. They are strong points, so you don't want to induce labor too early. We start discussing all the points now. There are a few points. I start with a gallbladder 21, which is on the gallbladder meridian. As I say, the meridian always the points are always bilateral. Okay, so basically, as you can see from the picture, is the most tender point along pathway between C7, cervical 7, and tip of shoulder joint, acromion process, at the top of the trapezium muscle. Basically, you need usually the point, the acupressure point, especially particularly gallbladder 21, is a tender point. So you need to go by the woman feedback. She will let you when she feel more tender, not painful, but just more like a more tender and bilateral. Okay. What is the technique? As I say, you need to apply. You need to apply firm downward pressure. You can use your thumb, knuckles, or elbow. I usually start gently and increase the pressure to tolerance. Okay, I start gently, then I increase. What I usually do, I start to apply gentle pressure at the beginning of the contraction, and then the pressure can be intensified during contraction. Okay. What is the clinic? Every point I'm discussing, just going to give a little bit indication of what is the what do they do basically. Gallbladder 21 is very good for relaxing because it relaxes the tendon and helping the woman to relax generally. So that is important because a lot of the time women can be quite tense if they are in pain. Feedback from midwives and from my personal practice has shown that this point is particularly used during the second stage of labor, as it allows the head to descend. It's got a very good descending properties. Obviously, if the head descends quicker, she will feel the second stage will last shorter and she will feel less pain. And then another point is bladder 32, which is located over the second sacrum's foramen. What the woman feel about is a dull, arched sensation. She feel like a sharp sensation is a bone. From my experience, this is a very good point, especially to use at the beginning of labor. It's very good for if you want to go backache. And as I say, from the feedback I got from women, is the most useful point for pain relief in labor. What is the technique? You apply firm pressure by placing knuckles into the point, okay? And you can apply maximum pressure is achieved when the woman is rocking back into your hand, like you provide counter pressure, okay? Another way women can use this point if they are alone, they are using like using a tennis ball against the wall to lean back into Dorian contraction. Okay, as I mentioned before, this point has got a very good, produce a very good pleasure and aesthetic effect. Okay. I mentioned before, I just this is because I'm going to discuss acupressure and water birth. I use this in, I'm going to discuss a case, clinical case I use, acupressure and water birth. As I say, I found very useful. As you can see from the picture, it's like, I believe that the birth is like, it's a social event. This is a family involved, okay? The man obviously might use like a pressure point on gallbladder in, gallbladder 21, the woman at the back, and the midwife is actually checking in a way, so supporting, she's there with the woman. Okay, so the case study I'm going to discuss is one of my case studies, as I say, was a water birth at home. Okay, I started using the prima gravida, I started using bladder 32, which was very good for making pain relief. She was very coping very well with the pain. However, at one point, I noticed that the head was not descending. Although she was fully dilated, the head was not descending. And she was not pushing the head to push. So I decided to use gallbladder 21, which definitely really helped her because the head was descending more, but more than anything else, she felt the head to push more. And she had a nice normal delivery on with the second stage lasting only 1 hour. So, as I say, gallbladder 21 is a good point to use on the second stage of labor because you got, when the head is not descending, reduce the pain, shorten the second stage of labor. I'm going to discuss another point, large intestine 4. Large intestine 4 is a good point a woman can use for herself, basically. It's on the dorsal of the hand between the first and second metatarsal bone. This is a very good point for any, if you got any pain, basically. If you got headache, any pain. Okay, if you're not expecting a baby. Okay. What is the technique? You apply firm pressure with your tongue. Can see from the picture, the woman can do this for herself. It is a very energetic point as it is tonified the chi. I tend to use this point when the woman is very tired on the transition. Okay, this will just give her more energy and she will feel better. Okay. Another good point is kidney one. Is the location of kidney one. Is the depression found in the top third of the sole of the foot. You need to apply strong pressure inward and upward towards the big toes. Kidney one is a very good point to help with during transition, anytime, basically, the woman she's carrying labor. And from my experience, when women are having labor work, they tend to be tense. So I use this point and the contraction start. Or even if they have like a previous traumatic birth, kidney one is a very good point. It's really relaxing, calming the mind. And it seems as well to release oxytocin, which is this oxytocin, as I mentioned before, is calming, is a hormone that relax and make them feel better. Another way, a way of using this kidney one is to apply seasickness band with a button. Apply pressure to the kidney one, or you can use pumpkin or sesame seed, always the plaster. Apply both to the kidney one bilateral, so the women can move around in labor. They can be squatting and helping them to relax. Another good point is combs. As well, this is very practical. Women can bring combs to labor ward or even use them at home. You need to, the location is place teeth or comb along palm of hand where finger join palm. And women can grip combs when doing contraction as required, so they are in control of the situation. What the combs seem to do is that we are putting the point on the point where it increases the endorphin, and there is as well some acupuncture point which seem to help him to relax. Okay? That's why it seems to work. And from experience, it's a very good way of helping women to pain. If we're thinking about using the point, I just wanted to give a general view because you might, I might be asking, you know, which point to use. As I say, I discuss few points. It just depends on women's choice in a way. You have to go by the women feedback. So you start using the point and you notice that which point women prefer. From my experience before, women really like bladder 32 because they've seen that when you stop using it, they want you to use again. So it's definitely very good for pain. You can use it all the time. A kidney one is another good point where women feel more relaxed because, as I say before, sometimes labor doesn't start. I had one case like this when she had a water birth. The labor definitely didn't start. I use a lot kidney one because she was just dealing with fear. So sometimes just one point is good. So as I say, you need to evaluate, try different points. Going back to the why do I think acupressure improve equity in health for all, which is the theme of this year international conference. I believe that it seems that women, by using acupressure, they can use like, they can feel empowered. Okay, they don't have to rely on other people, on other resources. But as I say, it's very cheap, it's very easy to use. It's really, should be made really accessible. Okay, so by using acupressure for pain relief, they can have a better choice. And I believe that they should start using, they should be encouraged to use it. And as I said before, offer more choice to women. And so basically, I really think that acupressure for pain relief in labor can feel women, can make feel women feel better. Empower, they are in charge of their health. As I say, I repeat, they don't have to rely on other people, on doctors. And this definitely increases their self-esteem. And like as I said before, body and mind is related in Chinese medicine. If you feel better, after you've done something for yourself mentally, you physically, you feel better, your health will improve, you got a good memory about your birth and delivery. And this is a challenge, obviously. What we can do to help women to achieve good health through acupressure as well. It is difficult for not speaking English to be able to practice acupressure technique. So I know that it's more used in a country where, you know, people, English is the main languages, okay? Like they use a lot in Australia, in New Zealand, acupressure for pain relief. And so what it can be the solution? Midwives should provide translation serving for this. They should be, you know, women should be, because it's important they know the point, the pattern for in their own languages. And otherwise, I believe that the service, because as I mentioned before, the service is cheap and help to reduce cesarean section and the use of epidural and the medicalization, I believe that all the trust, all the hospital, all the service, maternity service should offer this this acupressure service if they want to increase equity for all. I'm really happy. Thank you for listening. I just want to okay, there is some links with the video, some video. If you can go on the Rizosoma YouTube, you can see all the video with the point location. Okay. And then you can just wanted to, I just wanted to know if you want some more information regarding training, acupressure, moxibustion from pregnancy and birth, you can contact. This is my email. At the moment, I just be doing some sort of online, not much. I really prefer to do sort of a face to face, so in future. Okay, this is my email. Anything you want more information on the subject, just contact me. Thank you for listening. It was very.
Wow.
I'm open to any questions.
Thank you so much, Loredana. Thank you so much for that beautiful presentation. So interesting, packed filled with information. And like most of us are hearing this probably for the first time. And this is really useful information. Thank you once again. Thank you so much. So this is time for question and answer. And we already got some in the chat box. We already got some, so I'll read them out for you. So the first question is saying, what kind of training do you suggest that would help midwives and birth workers become competent in the use of acupressure? So this person is asking, what specific training would you suggest to help midwives and professionals? And let me quickly add on to that question that, aside the kind of training, how long do you think it would take anyone to learn, an interested person who wants to learn this, a midwife, how long would it take to learn acupressure?
Okay, I can talk from my own experience. As I say, I've been doing a lot of workshops in Italy and internationally. I believe that one day, okay, 8 hours is enough. But you need to be practical, you show all the point. And as I say, I've been teaching in different hospitals as well. The nice thing is that if you teach all the staff in one hospital or all in one, it's very sort of a, it's not like, obviously, if you're using acupuncture, you need a more training, like I did 4 year training. So use it with acupressure, I believe in 8 hours. Although I really believe that 8 hours is a minimum, I don't think that you should just learn and propose the point to people that just reading from the book and things. So, as I repeat myself, 8 hours, good workshop will help you. Yeah.
Awesome, awesome. That's very brilliant. 8 hours. Like, so I spent 8 hours and I gained all of the skills. Beautiful. Another person is asking that is it used for induction? Tool for induction or something?
There's been a very, I think it has been a lot. If you go on the Rhizosome Deborah Beth website, it's very good for induction. There has been a few points. I know I usually teach when I do the workshop I do, I tend to teach acupressure for induction and labor preparation as well. So definitely, because it seemed to increase, make the flow, especially there is a point, just mention one point, split six, which is seen to sort of make the circulation, the cervical ripening, pre-improve the cervical ripening. There's been a lot of research regarding this. So definitely, yes, it's very good.
Oh, thank you so much. Another person is asking that it's interesting to hear about the combs. That's Grace Dawson saying that. It's not something she's come across before, but does the kind of comb matters? So
no,
that was from his presentation.
No, it's very interesting. I think it just they need to be sort of a like she can have two combs in a way. So in a way, not too big, basically. Okay. It's just the location of the point stimulate endorphin. This is very interesting because it's been used the combs for many. It was quite popular in Russia, apparently. I've seen once, even before I was sort of doing any acupressure training, acupuncture, I saw a woman arriving there with the combs. So, yeah, it's something that is worth considering. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So I think that has been answered. Another question here says, can it be used for any other kind of pain relief aside labor and pregnancy and all that?
Yes, I think I just want to mention two points. I think large intestine 4, which I mentioned before, is good for that. Okay. And then another point is spleen 6. I know it's not on my PowerPoint, but spleen 6. However, don't use with women before 37 weeks because it's an induction point. However, spleen 6 is a very good point. It's on the leg, bilateral, on the spleen meridian. It's a very good point for if you go like pain, period pain, like menstrual pain, okay? Oh. Period pain, yeah?
Okay.
As I say, don't use before 37 weeks, please.
Oh, all right, yeah. So I think a lot of us, including myself, has found this very interesting and useful information. Thank you. But there's a comment here about acupuncture. She says she believes that the practice will work in synergy with other modalities, herbal medicine, massage, and also considering the birth environment. But I have a question to, you know, just to hook onto that. That is this used all over the world? You know, I'm just interested. What does the evidence say about its use on a global scale? also, are there cultural undertones to this, to the use, you know? What has been the finding in terms of cultural acceptance and all of that?
Yes, I think it just depends. Acceptance is very, as I say, it's not because in Italy it's very well, is used a lot, because as I say, the more you teach, the more midwives are involved. And I got very good feedback by using it. And I think in New Zealand, it use a lot, because in New Zealand, 60% of, because of Deborah Beth, so 60% of midwives use acupuncture. So they tend to use acupressure as well. And it's very, they got very good results. In Australia, it's very popular. I think it should be more popular. This is my sort of impression. In England as well, it's starting to get it because it's starting training now. It all comes to training and education, because it's been good. Where they use a lot, they got very good result, getting good research, and midwives are very happy. So, question answer to question, just it should be more used widely. Should be more used. There is the potential for using it more widely.
Awesome. Thank you so much again, Loredana. So talking about skills, competencies, you know, techniques that midwife can use to stand out as professionals that we are. Yeah, this is something we need to learn about and understand. Thank you so much again for this presentation.